Will the stock market crash before Christmas? That's what we're going to figure out in this market review video. You can see, as of this recording, things are already looking shaky, which is a little concerning right before Christmas. You know, there's low volume this week, meaning not many people are trading because they're on vacation. So what's going to happen? Are we going to see a big down move into the holidays? No Santa Claus rally this year? Or will we get the usual move higher and this is just an off few days? So we're going to go over the data to determine what's the highest probability scenario, and then, of course, what you should do about it. As always, you know we got our research from MacroOps backing us up. So the first thing we want to look at is positioning, and one of the ways we can do that is with this fund manager survey. And you can see that fund managers are holding their lowest cash position since early 13, triggering Bank of America's cash rule sell signal. So what's all this mean? Well, if you look at this chart, you can see what people have said they're holding, and these are fund managers, right? So professionals, the smart money, you could call them. And you'll see right here, they're very low in cash. And if they're low in cash, what that means is that they don't have much more money to put into the stock market. So that's a bad sign. If all the fund managers are fully invested, where is more buying pressure going to come from? Because you need people wanting to buy stocks, or, you know, having enough ammo and firepower, meaning cash, to buy it for the stock prices to keep going up. So that's why we track cash levels when we can to see how much cash is still left to go into the market. Because again, like I say in every video, when it comes to the stock market, it goes back to economics 101, supply and demand. And demand is how much cash is sitting on the sidelines. So they're at their lowest cash positions, meaning they're fully invested since early 2013. And that has triggered Bank of America's cash rule sell signal, because they're looking at it the same way. Too much cash already in the market, then where are prices left to go? If there's no buying, the only thing they can do is sell. So that's why it's a sell signal. And you can see right here that investor optimism is at its highest level since January 2018. And in here, it's the blue lines behind this black line, which is obviously the index. So investors are very, very optimistic. And this ties into what we were talking about before, because it all falls under sentiment analysis. Same thing here. If investors are super optimistic, what does that mean? They've been investing this whole time, right? They have all their money in the market. So again, if all their money is the market, who's left to buy? So when we look at sentiment, we want to see the inverse. We want to see a bunch of investors really pessimistic and bearish, because that means they haven't fully invested and they still have money. They still have time to turn bullish. And when they do, what is that going to do? It's going to push stock prices higher. But if everybody's super bullish, then who's left to convert? That's why you see market crashes when there is euphoria in the market. Think 2000 or 2008. In 2000, people loved tech stocks like crazy, right? Everything you bought went up. It was euphoric. 2008, same type of thing, but with how And when are the best times to invest? When everyone is super bearish, right? 2009 bottom, everyone thought the economy was going to be over, meaning there is a lot of fuel for that bull market that took off that's still running today. So when it comes to sentiment, you want to see more bears, because that's going to give us bulls more fuel. And by the way, if you hear the crunching, this is Luna the dog with her toy making all that noise. We got a DNA test thinking she was a black lab. Turns out 50% pit bull, even more than 50% actually. Then she's like a 20% golden retriever, 10% German shepherd, 10% husky, and some other stuff, but completely lied to us. Huge liar, told us she was a lab, not a single percentage of lab in her. And we thought she was gonna be a big dog, and then the vet told us that she's only gonna be 30 pounds, so I don't know what's going on. Might have to return her, especially for all the noises she makes in these videos. Okay, back to playing. Moving on, we can look at Bank of America's bull and bear indicator, which is another sentiment indicator, because we want to look at multiple, right? We don't want to just look at one indicator and make a decision. You got to look at multiple data points and put together a thesis, which is exactly what we're doing in this video, right? We do this every week. So the Bank of America bull bear indicator hit 6.7. And look, it says exactly what I was talking about before. When there's extreme bullishness, it triggers a sell signal. When there's extreme bearishness, that triggers a buy signal. So it says right here at the bottom in March, this was a zero, extreme buy signal, because everyone was so pessimistic. Now it's hitting 6.7, and the recent high was 7.1 in January. So we're getting into that people are, you know, too bullish, that territory, which is a bearish sign for the market once again. The dumb money confidence indicator that we look at is at its highest level ever. You see this blue line? This is the dumb money, real confident. Why? Because Tesla just keeps going up. Not really, but yeah, that's what it seems like. Again, just more sentiment indicators, and dumb money is what they consider retail traders. Sorry, guys. It's very very offensive. I'm surprised they still use that word in 2020. But that's us. More data we could look at is ETF fund flows, and it shows that people are piling into stocks. Look at this green line right here, just shooting up. More and more people in, who's left to buy? Foreigners included are backing up the truck on US equities. This blue line shooting up higher. Everybody wants a piece around the world. And you guys know small caps have been absolutely on fire. Well, you can see now they are so extended and making this pattern that looks pretty bearish. They're ready to fall as well. So if we look at the charts, and right here is the monthly chart, meaning that each bar represents 1 month in the S&P 500, we can see that November was a pretty bullish bar. And that's that little one right here that ended up higher than the previous month. So that was a bullish signal. And based off that signal, we were saying that December should be positive. Now, so far, that has held true. If we look at November right here, closed November 30th, to right now, we are up almost 1%. So it's just barely true. It's less than 1%. But a lot of that was taken away by just this big red bar right here. And we still got to see what happens. But based off our monthly analysis, we should be bullish into the end of the year. The issue, though, is that trend fragility has become very high. So the trend is fragile because we're so overextended. And I already showed you all the sentiment, right? And the positioning. People are overextended and way too excited. So there's only about, well, by the time this video goes out, maybe 7 trading days left in the year. And like I was saying before, light volume in holiday trading should carry the market higher. And that's what they call the Santa Claus rally, that every Christmas, the stock market usually goes up going into Christmas. But look at this bar right now. This is not looking like a good day. So in our analysis, we think the market should continue to go up into the end of the year, but there is a chance that it does reverse. Either way though, like we've been saying in these videos going back, January is not looking good. We should see a good correction, at least 10%. Because once again, of all the sentiment that has been building up and all the mispositioning, when the market gets too hot, it has to take a breather. Not saying that the overall bull market is over, just saying that there will be a correction coming. So of course the question is, what do you do with your investments? Well, here's what I'm gonna do. Throughout this whole period, I'm going to continue to manage my risk. Because let me tell you what most people do. They are still stuck in the buy the dip mentality. And what they're thinking is, regardless of what the market does, if it goes down, we're just gonna buy more and then buy some more. And the hope is that everything is gonna work out just like Tesla did. It could get shot, dragged through a ditch, and somehow it always comes back. And honestly, with the way that this market rebounded in March, yeah, people are gonna think that because there's so much support. But here's the issue. Eventually, that support from the Fed, the printing, the checks, it's all gonna run out. Even if they're still doing it, I'm not saying they're gonna stop, but the expectation of the market, whatever they're doing is not gonna meet it, and that's when you're gonna see a serious decline and not a massive rebound. Like the whole March thing was crazy, and it made the people not controlling their risk look like geniuses, when in fact, no, you probably made the bad move of holding and buying more. And it wasn't a bad move during that specific situation, but over the long run, if you play out enough of those scenarios, that's how you blow out. And that's why I'm here. That's why I'm making these videos, just to remind everyone that no, it ends at some point. And the whole reason for risk control is to protect yourself when it does end, when it doesn't rebound. And it gets very difficult for people to keep managing their risk when a lot of times, yeah, it does reduce your returns when this market is going straight up and every dip is bought and it just, you know, keeps getting supported. But that's the thing about managing risk. You're waiting for that time where it doesn't come back. And that's where the professional managers absolutely crush everyone else. And it's not just crushing everyone else in that specific year where the big crash happens. Their ability to cut off that huge drop that everyone else goes through, that puts them ahead for years. Why? Because when they start building their capital again, right? When the market starts going up, they're starting from up here. Everyone else is starting from down here. So at the end of 10 years into the future, they've made way more money because of compounding and just larger numbers. So really, you can't think about the short game. You need to think about the long-term game, because you're in this, what, until retirement for at least another 30 years? Basically your whole life. So you got to constantly remind yourself of that and remind yourself to manage that risk, even when it looks like the market will never fall and that you should keep buying every time it goes down. And this is really where the most important part about investing comes in, more than your strategy or anything, it's your psychology. Because you need to be able to control yourself through these times. And like I said, it's not easy sticking to this stuff, especially when you look at everyone else around you doing the opposite of good risk management and making a bunch of money. Just got to keep reminding yourself that you're playing for the long term. So like we said, December, the market may fall apart before Christmas, but January is a much higher odds of getting a correction. And again, we don't think it's going to be the massive correction, the massive bear market starting. We think it's going to be minor and the bull market will continue. But even so, these are probabilities. We can't make 100% prediction. If we could, we'd have all the money in the world. And that's why even though we say the probabilities are on that the market rebounds, we still manage our risk. If our stocks hit a risk point, we are selling them because we don't know for sure. And that's the job of an investment manager, to manage that uncertainty. That's why you don't even call yourself an investment manager when you are one. You call yourself a risk manager, because that's your real job. That's what separates you from everyone else, especially over the long term. That's what gets you the returns. And again, not easy to do because of the psychology, and that's why there's so few professional investors. It really comes down to controlling yourself. And Warren Buffett actually has a great interview talking about that. He talks about how important it is to have the right temperament in the market and to control your psychology. Now, we made a video about it, and I'm going to put it right here in this link. So click this link so you could go over to Buffett, and he explains it way better than me. And hopefully that could help you during this time. So click this video right here, and I will see you there.